let's get going. How can we go and attack the rest of the year in a way to set up the biggest possible month, to put us in position to set up the biggest possible year? Mm-hmm. And you can only be interested in this if you're not happy. It's really symptomatic of why nobody really does anything with what they hear. You know, why is it that oceans of people will pay $2,500, go to a Tony Robbins, go to a John Maxwell, buy the books, listen to the tapes, travel across the country, go to training courses, they never do anything. Same thing with people. We have 1,200 plus people listen to the 4-point game plan. I've taught it to where I can't even say it anymore. It looks like essentially nobody's doing it. People are doing it, but percentage-wise, essentially no one. I was frustrated with that with David, and we talking about why that is. Most people have to hear something 100 times. If you're a genius, you have to hear it 75 times before the light bulb goes on. Why is this? Because they're not paying attention. They've got distractions going on in their lives. They're really not motivated. The idea of doing something big is not really specific in mind. They don't have a big need. In a sense, it can be the greatest thing in the world for you if you have huge bills, huge things you need to buy and get, but you just don't have money for it. That's good, because that makes you pay attention. But for some reason, they don't pay attention. And I think what it is when you hear it over and over and over, eventually the timing is right. It's not that you weren't capable of hearing it, but for some reason, the timing wasn't quite there. Maybe you just didn't have enough experience in the industry, in the business, with what everybody's talking about for it to sink in. But for whatever reason, only 1 to 2% of the people will grab on in a big way. And the 80% will go out and they'll like it. They respond, but they average one success. You know, if it's signing up, you got to get in shape, you got to stop smoking. They'll have one little period, brief burst of activity and result, but then they fade away. 20% will sit in there and fool with it. And, you know, they'll fight, they'll work with it. And they might not have the great results because they don't really commit totally to it, but they work it. They at least keep trying. And as a result, they're going to have 20 times more success than this person here. But the person, the 1 to 2%ers will have 100 times and up, and they'll make $100 and up for every dollar the person in the bottom 80% works, because they take it dead serious. They make it work. They try and make the system work. They try and run the system. These people take the system, install it, and then they make it work. Once the system starts to bog down or it doesn't work the way it's supposed to, they dig in and they find some way to get it working again. They make things happen. They don't sit for the next training program to see what other ideas they can pick up. They come up with ideas, or they call people who would know the answer, like right away. They don't lose time. Whereas these right here immediately go to the assumption of, I'm not good enough, woe is me, let me teach it again. If I can just get myself to focus, if I can just get myself to work harder, if I can just get this and the other, where they go down the wrong hole to solve their problem. They need to go out and say, I'm working hard. I'm not getting the results. Either I'm doing it with the wrong people, or I've got some glitch in my understanding of how this works. You should be going to get an answer right away. That's what these people do. Like Jack Nicklaus, greatest golfer of all time. Still, Tiger hasn't passed him. Nicklaus was so confident in his ability that if he ever hit a putt, reporters would talk about this. They write articles about it. If he ever hit a putt and it didn't go in, he would say, something must be wrong with the ball. There must be something, a spike mark I can't see, the chewed off line, spike mark, or some other kind of thing. Somebody must have been messing with my putter, because I hit that thing solid. See, in their mind, they're going to do everything 100% right every time. They have their drill to do it, they set up to do it. If it goes wrong, it's out of their hands. Something went wrong. You might look at that as making excuses, and in a way it is making excuses, but it's for a purpose. See, down here people make an excuse, David. They make an excuse, and it's a reason to quit. It's a reason why they're not good enough. They're not as good as other people. They use it basically as a reason to back off, not try as hard, start looking at other things because, you know, it's not working because of some of these same things. Well, whereas the top guys, the Nicklaus, the Tiger Woods, they look at it and they say, okay, one thing we can be sure is the ball didn't go in and it ain't my fault because I did everything. See, that's the way a winner thinks. A winner thinks, I never make a mistake. I always do the right thing that I, based off the knowledge and experience I have at that moment in time. If I do it and it doesn't work out, then there's something else going on and I don't know about. I got to find out. And then they try and change it up. Is there something wrong with this ball? Is it out of round? Is there some kind of spike mark that the ball went over and caused it to jump offline? Is there something wrong with the club, my putter? Somebody might have bent it a little bit or it might have got out of true. But they'll go in there. They don't look. First of all, they say, I know it's not me and I'm going to fix it. Unacceptable. So I'm going to check the ball. I'm going to check this. I'm going to check that. I'm going to check everything I can and get back out there. And I'm going to unravel this mystery until I start draining those putts again like I know I should be draining them. See, that's what the 1% or 2%er does, David. Whereas the 20%ers, even though they work at it more than 80%er, they don't really give it everything because it's like, well, I did what I was supposed to do and it didn't work. I must not be good enough. Their default idea, impression of why anything doesn't work is I'm not good enough. Well, maybe you're talking to the wrong kind of people. Maybe you need to talk to more people. If the batting averages are 1 out of 3 in Major League Baseball, and the batting averages are 1 out of 3 in your office with prospecting, or 1 out of 10, whatever they are, you've got to think, if you talk to one person, you can't expect to hear a yes until you get enough in there to where the normal law of averages can kick in. That's why you've got to do the high numbers. You know, you're never going to get the 100%. So you can't just do it one time. I'm not good enough. Throw it up and go try something else. That's where people lose focus. That's why they try 1,000 things. They never buckle down. And it's getting in shape, learning a new instrument. But see, then what happens is you have this in the entry level, but then you have this on, let's just say, of these 1-2%ers. Let me take those. Go back to that. So of the 1-2%ers, even those, see, they'll drive it to a higher level 100 times here, but you still, at every level, you have the 80-20 rule and the 1-2%. You have the 1-2%ers at the rep level. They come in and they win the Fast Start Awards and they race through the system quick and they move up to the district level. But hey, do they automatically go up here? No. 80% of them will make one major run, David, after they go to district, and then they'll settle down. Maybe 1 out of 5 will stay in there and work the system. But if you get enough districts, see, the reason you don't have any super successful districts is you don't have enough of them. But if you have enough of them, sooner or later, someone's going to approach and they're going to work it like a maniac. They're going to make it work. And then from that, those are going to be the people who quickly accelerate to the next level. At the next level, you've got to play the odds, folks. Now, you might get lucky, but see, it's a funnel. It's an 80-20 rule funnel at every level. For example, let's say the first time anybody got a job working in Washington, D.C. in government, not a paid, they were an intern. Do all interns make politics their careers? No. They might start as an intern. Then the next year, the real serious ones, a very 80-20 rule again, will go and they'll make it, they'll come back as a paid. Or they'll come back for the second interview. And then they'll work in and they'll come on staff. And then they'll go to chief of staff. They'll work on campaigns. They'll work their way up, bigger and bigger positions. And then eventually, they'll run themselves. You can get a handful of people and hope you luck up and get a 1-2%er. Or you can build a factory that turns these things out and you can guarantee you get the 1-2%ers. And this has to do with building an organization. So it works the same way on building clients as it does in terms of building an organization. You know, even the Army works that way. Of the kids who go through basic training, it works out just like this. They all have to run around, get in shape, do all of the basic minimal stuff. But what do they do with it after they get through training? It falls into this line right here. 80% of them might have one good trip over to Europe or a campaign. 20% of them will be signing back up and making it a lifetime type thing. But then 1 or 2% of them will grab hold of it, make it an obsession, and move all the way up the ranks, become officers and become higher and higher officers, because they just driven up to get the big picture. They want to go all the way to the top. That is a takeoff on, you know, elaborating on why more people don't do more. But an extension that it has for us, I would say, is the fact that you can decide. See, this is when you're working with other people, but you can decide, I've tried this approach before, and it makes me sick to my stomach. I'm moving up to this level. I'm ready to be a 1 or 2 percenter. The idea is, until you decide to do that, and you start making these runs where you say, I'm going to go out there and make the next month my finest hour. I'm going to find what worked for me before. When in my past have I really been in charge, really made a lot happen in a short period of time in anything? And you get back in that mindset and you start writing things down of how you got that done. Then you start applying those things to where you are now, and you get on the attack, and then you start learning other things. And then you go out there and make a run for it. And you'll probably miss your target the first time, but you'll get yourself more organized and you'll learn what the missing pieces are. Well, then you'll set up the run. I'm going to start the new year. I'm going for my finest year. I'm going to have my best first quarter ever, my best start. And you take the lessons you learned and you apply them in here with the stuff that's worked for you in the past. And guess what? You're going to have better results. But even if you miss your mark, you're going to see the things you need to learn. And you come out of that, you set another target. But that's how you turn to where you get yourself in liftoff. And your career starts to take off because step by step, you're improving, you're driving yourself because you made a decision. I'm sick and tired of mediocrity. I don't want to be average anymore. I want to do something great with my life, and I'm tired of wasting my time. And the quicker I get it done, the quicker I can enjoy the place I work myself up to.